It's good to get back to filming. It's been a while. Good morning. Today we are going to learn about the basics of an LR circuit.
Flippin' physics.
This LR circuit is a circuit with a battery, a resistor, an inductor, and a switch. Before time t equals zero, the switch is open and has been open for a long time. At time t equals zero, the switch is closed and remains closed. Bo, tell me what we know about the initial current in the circuit, the current at time zero.
Well, the switch has been open for a while before the switch is closed. So before the switch is closed, the current in the open circuit is zero. After the switch is closed, current flows through the circuit. So after the switch is closed, current flows through the circuit.
I think you forgot about the inductor in the circuit. Inductors oppose changes in current. We talked about that last time.
Yeah. The inductor opposes changes in current in the circuit, so because there was no current in the circuit before the switch is closed, right when the switch is closed, the current is initially zero.
But after a long time, the current will have increased to its maximum current and will stay at that current.
The steady state current.
Right, so after a long time, the current in the circuit is not changing, so the inductor has no change in current to oppose, so it's basically like the inductor is not there after a long time.
Correct. The current at time equals zero is zero. And the current after a long time is at its maximum value because the current in the circuit is no longer changing. It has increased to a steady state current, and the inductor has zero resistance to the current because the inductor is made of a coiled up ideal wire with zero resistance. But we can actually determine the equations for the limits. To do that, Bobby, please apply Kirchhoff's loop rule to the circuit starting in the lower left-hand corner.
Well, Kirchhoff's loop rule states that the electric potential difference around a loop equals zero, starting in the lower left-hand corner and moving clockwise in the direction of current, that equals, well, we add the EMF of the battery because the electric potential difference across the battery in the direction of the current is from the negative terminal to the positive terminal across the battery. In other words, the electric potential increases across the battery in the direction of current. Then we subtract the electric potential difference across the resistor because the electric potential decreases across the resistor in the direction of the current. And we subtract the electric potential difference across the inductor because the electric potential also decreases across the inductor in the direction of current when current is increasing as it is here. And we can substitute current times resistance in for the electric potential difference across the resistor, and inductance times the derivative of current with respect to time for the electric potential difference across the inductor.
I thought the induced EMF across an inductor equaled the negative of inductance times the time rate of change of current. Why did you not include the negative when substituting in the equation for electric potential difference across the inductor?
Because we already showed the electric potential difference across the inductor goes down in the direction of increasing current through an inductor in the Kirchhoff's loop rule equation. If we included the negative from the induced EMF equation, that would make it so the electric potential across the inductor would go up across an inductor in the direction of current when it is increasing, which does not make sense.
Yeah, we already included the direction. Thanks.
Well done. Thanks. Billy, please use the equation Bobby just gave us to determine the remaining limits for this LR circuit.
Absolutely. Well, we know that at the time initial, time t equals zero, the initial current equals zero. When we substitute that into the Kirchhoff's loop rule equation, we get zero equals EMF minus inductance times the derivative of current with respect to time. We can rearrange that equation to get that the derivative of current with respect to time equals EMF divided by inductance. In other words, the initial value for the time rate of change of current in the inductor equals EMF over inductance. We also know that after a long time, or time is roughly equal to infinity, the final time rate of change of current in the circuit equals zero. When we substitute that into the Kirchhoff's loop rule equation, we get zero equals EMF minus current times resistance. We can rearrange that to get current final equals EMF divided by resistance. In other words, our limits for current are that it starts at zero and increases to EMF divided by resistance. And that means EMF divided by resistance is the maximum value this circuit will have. As we said earlier, after a long time, the circuit behaves as if the inductor is not there, because this is the value the current in the circuit would have if there were no inductor in the circuit. And the other limits are that the derivative of current with respect to time starts at a value of EMF divided by inductance and decreases to zero. And that means EMF divided by inductance is the maximum value the time rate of change of current will have in this circuit.
Thank you, Billy. And thank you for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.